Here on this lecture 19 on applications of monotone convergence theorem by Dr. P. Ramlu, Head Department of Mathematics, MBS Government Arts and Science College, Mahabubnagar. Already we have discussed about the monotone convergence theorem and problems of monotone convergence theorem. Today I am also going to solve problems of monotone convergence theorem. That means I want to apply the MCET monotone convergence theorem to solve the given problems. What is monotone convergence theorem? All bounded monotone sequence are converges. All bounded monotone convergence sequence are converges, right? That means an increasing bounded equal sequence is converges, a decreasing bounded equal sequence is converges, right? This thing we have to already discussed. Now I want to solve some other problems. I want to solve some other problems. If the sequence, right? If the sequence SN is defined by, if the sequence SN is defined by S1 greater than 0 and Sn plus 1 equal to 1 by 2 Sn plus A by Sn, then show that Sn is converges to root A. Then show that Sn is converges to root A. And we are here, A is positive. A is positive number. If the sequence Sn is defined by S1 is greater than 0 and Sn plus 1 equal to 1 by 2 Sn plus A by Sn, then to show that Sn is converges to root A, A is positive. The sequence Sn is defined by S1 is greater than 0 and Sn plus 1 equal to 1 by 2 Sn plus A by Sn. Sn plus 1 equal to 1 by 2 Sn plus A by Sn. And 2 Sn equal to what happen if I multiply here? This in place of n plus I am substituting n, in place of n I am substituting n minus 1. Then what happen in place of n if I substitute n minus 1? 2 Sn is equal to Sn minus 1 whole square. We are not playing this Sn square, Sn minus whole square plus A by Sn minus 1. This thing I know. By cross multiply this, what happened? 2 Sn, Sn minus 1, Sn minus 1 whole square plus A. 2 Sn, Sn minus 1, Sn minus 1 whole square plus A. Right? If I multiply these two things. So, whatever here, Sn minus whole square 2 Sn into Sn minus 1 plus A equal to 0. It is in the form of quadratic equation in Sn minus 1. It is in the form of Ax square plus Bx plus C equal to 0. This is quadratic equation in Sn minus 1. Discriminant here, discriminant is B square minus 4AC equal to 0. Since S1 is greater than 0, since S1 is positive and S1 is in a sequence, right? S1 is a positive. Okay. And Sn is a sequence of real numbers. S1 is positive and Sn is a sequence of real numbers. Discriminant, if I find discriminant B square minus 4A is equal to greater than 0, here B nothing but it is the form Ax square Bx plus C. B nothing but 2Sn, C nothing but A nothing but 1. So if you substitute here, B square minus 4AC with greater than equal to 0, minus 2Sn whole square minus 4AC, that equal 4Sn whole square minus 4A. If I take 4 common out, Sn minus Sn square minus A, 2 root Sn square minus A, which is greater than equal to 0. From this. So, which implies what happened? Sn square minus A also greater than equal to 0. Sn square minus A also greater than 0. Which implies Sn square is greater than equal to A. Sn is greater than equal to root A, that equal to 1. Sn is greater than equal to A. That thing here, I found that lower bound of Sn is root A. Lower bound of Sn is root A. Let I am considering Sn plus 1 by 1 by 2 Sn plus 1 by A. This Sn plus 1 already defined. I am considering here Sn minus Sn plus 1, that equal to Sn here, this is minus, minus of Sn plus 1 terms, this Sn. If I cross multiply, then what happen? 1 plus Sn minus 1 by 2, Sn into Sn square plus A by Sn, that equal to 2 Sn square minus Sn square minus A by 2 Sn. Here it is in the form of say Sn square minus A equal Sn square minus A by 2 Sn. Already we know that Sn square minus A is greater than 0. This also positive number, this also greater than 0. This is greater than 0, this is greater than 0, all of the things is greater than 0. Which implies Sn minus Sn square, Sn minus Sn plus 1 is greater than equal to 0 for all n belongs to n. Sn is greater than equal to Sn plus 1 for all n belongs to n. That means Sn is decreasing sequence. By definition of decreasing sequence, we know that Sn greater than equal to Sn plus 1 for all n belongs to n. Sn is greater than equal to Sn plus 1 for all n belongs to n. Which implies Sn is decreasing sequence. Sn is decreasing. We show that Sn is decreasing, then Sn is monotone. Sn is monotone sequence. Since Sn is decreasing, we know that the upper bound of Sn is decreasing, right? The upper bound of Sn is the bounded above. Upper bound can be bounded above. Upper bound of Sn is S1. What is S1? S1, Sn is greater than S1. For all n belongs to, why? Because this is decreased sequence. Sn less than equal to S1 for all n belongs to n. S1 is positive number. I don't know about the upper bound. That is one positive number. It may be 1, 2, 3, might be. Already one from one, I know that Sn is greater than equal to root A. That means root A less than equal to Sn is less than equal to S1. Here from 2, we know that Sn is less than S1. From A, from 1, we know that root A is less than or equal to Sn less than or equal to n for all n belongs to n. That means Sn is bounded and Sn is monotone. From 1, Sn is bounded, Sn is monotone and bounded. Already know that, we show you that Sn is monotone and Sn is bounded. By, if I applying monotone convergence theorem, by applying monotone convergence theorem, Sn is converges. We know that all bounded monotone sequences are converges. All bounded monotone sequences are converge. That thing I know. So applying the theorem, here we get that the monotone sequence is converges, the limit Sn is converges, and limit Sn equal to L. Limit of Sn equal to L. So Sn is bounded and monotone, Sn is converges, limit Sn equal to L. It is converges. We show that limit Sn converges to root A. Limit of Sn is converges to this term. We know that the lower bound of Sn is root A, right? A decreasing bounded below sequence is converges to infimum. By applying monotone convergence theorem, same here, lower bound root A, you can apply either like this also. Now I am finding what is limit Sn, is converges to root A or not. Let I am considering limit Sn equal to L. Limit of Sn equal to L. Limit Sn equal to L, which implies limit of Sn plus 1 equal to what happened? L. Limit of Sn plus 1 also L. What is limit of Sn plus 1? Sn plus 1 nothing but limit of of times of Sn plus A by Sn, that equal to L. Apply limit here. Limit of Sn equal to L plus A by L, that equal to L. Which implies L square plus A, L square plus A, here we get 2L, it comes this side, L square plus A, that equal to 2L square. L square comes this side, L square equal to A, L equal to plus or minus 2, L equal to root A. Why? Because S1 is positive, that means I have sequence term all only positive, it cannot be negative. It converges to only positive terms, that doesn't mean negative, therefore limit Sn equal to L. L nothing but limit Sn. Limit of Sn equal to root A. Therefore, Sn is converges to root A. So, we shown that our sequence Sn is converges to root A. Right? So, this thing I have already explained. Right? Lemniscence is colonized tree. If the sequence Sn is defined by Sn equal to 5, Sn equal to Sn minus 1 whole square plus 5 by root 2 Sn minus 1 for all n greater than 2, then show that the sequence Sn converges to root 5. If the sequence Sn is defined by Sn equal to 5, Sn equal to Sn square minus 1 plus 5 by 2 Sn minus 1 for all n greater than 2, then show that the sequence Sn is converges to root 5. Sequence Sn is converges to root 5. We have to show this. So, what can I do? Same, it is a similar problem. If I consider this, so, okay, same like this, so you can take Sn equal to this. Sn plus 1 equal to same Sn plus 1 equal to Sn square plus 5 by 2 Sn. What to do? We can do cross multiply. We can apply cross multiply. We can find discriminant. Here S1 is equal to 5. We can find discriminant. So if a discriminant, we will get Sn square plus 5 is greater than Sn square minus 5 is greater than equal to 0. Oh, in place of A, we have here A. In place of A, we have here 5. Last problem we have discussed in place of A. Simply replace 5, replace A by 5. Okay. In place of A, you can substitute A, we will get same answer. So, cross multiply and we will get required answer to solve this. Right? So, this is practical answer. Let Sn be a sequence of positive numbers. Let Sn be a sequence of let Sn be increasing sequence of positive numbers. Let Sn be a increasing sequence of positive numbers and define sigma Sn that equal to 1 by n of S1 plus S2 plus data as Sn. Prove that sigma Sn is increasing sequence. Prove that sigma Sn is increasing sequence. Our sequence is defined. This is practical problem, that's why I am defining here required aim. The aim, if Sn is an increasing sequence of positive numbers, so and sigma Sn equal to 1 by n S1 plus S2 plus data as Sn, then to prove that sigma Sn is an increasing sequence, then to prove that sigma Sn is an increasing sequence. Principle of proving this, we have required sequence, increasing sequence. Right. Method. Let Sn be an increasing sequence. Let Sn be an increasing sequence. Which are the facts? S1 less than equal to, S2 less than equal to, S3 less than equal to, that as Sn less than equal to Sn plus 1 for all n greater than n. I am putting the star. Let sigma n defined by, sigma n defined by 1 by n, or S1 plus S2 square, S2 plus Sn, sigma Sn plus 1 equal to 1 by n plus 1, S1 plus S2 plus data as Sn plus 1. So here, what I am doing here, sigma n I know, sigma n plus 1 I know, I want to here sigma n minus sigma n plus 1, sigma n minus sigma n plus 1, that equal to 1 by n, this is sigma n is 1 by n, sigma n plus 1 is what this, 1 by n plus 1, S1 plus S2 plus data Sn. I want to cross multiply here. I want to cross multiply here, n plus 1 by n plus n, right? Here what we get here, see, 1 times of S1 plus S2 plus Sn, n times of S1 plus S2 plus Sn, and n times of S1 plus S2 plus these terms all cancel out, required terms all S1 plus S2 plus data Sn minus n into Sn plus 1, S1 plus S2 plus Sn minus n into Sn plus 1, n into n plus 1, here n into n plus 1, the numerator is n plus, right? So, which is less than equal to, why? Because our Sn is increasing sequence. Our Sn is increasing sequence. S1 is less than equal to, quickly observe here, S1 is less than equal to, S2 less than equal to, S3 less than equal to, Sn plus 1, Sn is less than, right? You can observe this clearly,
These all terms are less than or equal to s1 is less than sn plus 1, s2 less than or equal to sn plus 1, s2 less than or equal to sn plus 1, and n into sn plus 1, I'm writing same as n plus 1 only. How many sn plus 1s are here? N. N times of sn plus 1, n times of sn plus 1. This will be 0. So that means sigma n minus sigma n plus 1 is less than or equal to 0 for all n belongs to n. Which implies sigma n is less than or equal to sigma n plus 1 for all n belongs to n. Sigma n less than or equal to sigma n plus 1 for all n belongs to n. Which implies sigma n is an increasing sequence. Sigma n is an increasing sequence. We have proved. So the given problem we have proved can result on your own. Right. So quickly observe here, I am considering section of increasing sequence. I want to show that sigma n defined like this. I want to show that sigma n is also increasing. But isn't this condition, only one condition is required here, sigma s1 s2 is, if it is applied this, it is enough. So what I am doing, I am considering sigma n plus 1 considering, I cross multiply, will get cancel, n times of this cancel out. And required time this, if I apply this whole terms of less than sn plus 1, these are n times of sn plus 1 and n times sn plus 1. Both are cancelled, they are equal to 0, where sigma n minus sigma n plus 1 is less than equal to 0, that is sigma n less than sigma n plus 1 for all n. Sigma n is an increased sequence, then you have to prove. So other practical problem, other problem you can do, yeah. Let t1 equal to 1 and tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus of 1 by 4 10 square tn over n greater equal to 1. Show that limit tn is exist. Show that limit tn is exist. What do you think of limit tn? What do you think of limit tn? So this is very important problem. Let t1 is defined by 1 and tn plus equal to 1 minus 4 n square into tn for n greater equal to 1. Then show that limit tn is exist. What do you think about limit tn? What do you think about limit tn? Aim. If a sequence tn is defined by t1 equal to 1 and tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 4 n square into tn 4 n greater equal to 1, then to show that limit tn is exist. Then to show that limit tn is exist. B. To discuss about the limit tn. To discuss about the limit tn. Principles, sequence, mathematical induction, bounded sequence, convergence, increasing sequence, decreasing sequence, monotone sequence, monotone convergence theorem, and Valley's product. What is Valley's product? This is very important. This is in my problem. This is very important. The Valley's product is I equal to 1 to infinity. This is product of I equal to 1 to infinity. These two terms, right? 2a minus 1 by 2n. 2n plus 1 by 2n, this is the product of this t equal to pi by 2, this is called Valley's product. This is called Valley's product method. Let the sequence tn is defined by t1 equal to 1 and tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 4n square into tn. A, tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 4n square into tn, that equal to 1 by dn, dn minus 1 by 2n square, which is less than to tn. Tn plus 1 is less than to tn for all n belongs to n. Tn is decreasing. Tn is decreasing, which implies Tn is monotone. Since Tn decreasing is monotone already, right? Here I found that Tn is decreasing already, you know that here Tn is monotone. Since Tn is decreasing, Tn is bounded above sequence. Decreasing, it is bounded above sequence. And the upper bound of Tn is T1. Upper bound of Tn is T1. Which implies Tn is less than or equal to T1 for all n belongs to n. Which implies Tn is less than or equal to Tn for all n belongs to n. T1 equal to 1, which implies Tn less than or equal to 1 for all n belongs to n. This is 1, equation 1. Let T1 equal to 0, which is greater than 0. T1 equal to 0, which is greater than 0. So, we are... T1 is so... I think this is equal. T1 is T2 equal to what happened here? T1 equal to 1 here. T1 equal to 1. This is 1 is greater than 0. T1 equal to 1, which is greater than 0. So here T1 equal to 1. T1 equal to 1, which is greater than 0. Right. T2. Our T2 is defined by T2 is 1 minus 1 by 4 T1. 1 minus 1 by 4 into T1, right? Tn equal to is defined as Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 4. Tn minus 1 equal to Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 1 by 4 n square 4 n square Tn. Right. Tn plus 1 equal to this, right? T2 equal to what happened here? 1 minus One minus four T1. T1 equal to 1. This is how much here? T1 equal to 1. If I have, this will be 3 by 4. Which is greater than 0. T2 also greater than 0. So, similarly, here we can observe T2 is equal to 0 and 0. It is true for T equal to 1. T equal to 1. It is true for T equal to 1. I am telling that it is true for T equal to K. N equal to K. Here it is true for N equal to 1. It is true for N equal to K. I want to prove that this is by mathematical induction. It is true for N equal to K, which implies TK is greater than 0. Which implies TK is greater than 0. So TK is greater than 0. I want to multiply this 1 minus 4k square by 1 minus something 1 by 4k square. You can take that. This is the positive number only. If I multiply this positive number and positive, they are also positive. 1 minus 4k square into TK is also greater. This is positive and this is also positive. So this is also positive. Which implies TK plus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. TK plus 1 is greater than or equal to 0. It is true for n equal to k plus 1. It is true for n equal to k plus 1. So by induction, it is true for all n belongs to n. That means t is greater than 0 for all n belongs to n. From 1 and 2, we know that 0 less than or equal to tn less than or equal to t1 is less than or equal to 1. So 0 less than or equal to t1 is less than or equal to 1 for all n belongs. That means tn is bounded. I know already know that tn is monotone. Tn is bounded and tn is monotone. By monotone convergent theorem. By monotone convergence theorem, Tn is convergence. Lim Tn is exists. Lim Tn is exists. Right? That means here I am showing that here I found that this limit of sequence is exists. Now, what do you think about the limit of the sequence? What do you think about the limit of sequence? So, B. Suppose if limit of Tn equal to L. Limit of Tn equal to L. So limit of Tn equal to what happened? If limit of Tn equal to L, which implies told me that limit of Tn plus 1 also 1. Limit of Tn plus 1 equal to L. Tn plus 1 nothing but 1 minus 4 n square into Tn that equal to L. Here limit of Tn equal to multiply this. So multiply this. Tn minus Tn by 4 n square equal to L. That is lim Tn. So lim Tn equal to L. Lima 4 n square that equal to L. L by infinite 0 L equal to L. So if I assume Tn equal to L, we are unable to find any value of L. That means here we get L equal to L only. We are unable to determine the limit. But we are unable to determine the limit by this matter. But T1 equal to 1, Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 4 n square by Tn. Tn plus 1 equal to what? If I cross multiply this, so if I cross multiply 4 n square minus 1 by 4 n square in Tn,
can simply describe it in the form of a square minus b square, like that 2n into 2n minus 1 and 2n plus 1, 2n into 2n minus 1 and 2n plus 1 by 4 square into t, and this is written as 2n minus 1 by 2n into 2n plus 1 by 2n. Tn plus 1 is equal to 2n minus 1 by 2n, 2n plus 1 by 2n, that is equal to it. So if I multiply this, we will get this. T2 equal to 1 by, what happen, 1 by 2 into 3 by 2. T2 equal to 1 by 2 into 3 by 2. Here multiply simply 1 by 2 into 3 by 2. T3 equal to what happen, 1 by 2 into 3 by 2 into 3 by 4, why? Why? Because this term into Tn. T nothing but this. T3 equal to T this term into T2. So T2 nothing but this, and T this term equal to right here. So similarly you can apply here. Simply you can apply T2. T2 here, I am writing T2 equal to that thing, but T1 equal to 1. If substitute n equal to 1 here, 2n minus 1 equal to 1 by 2. If substitute n equal to 1, 2n plus 1 equal to 3, 3 by 2. 3 by 2 will get. T3 equal to, if I remember this, n equal to 2. N equal to 2, if I put here n equal to, then what happen, n equal to 2n, 4 minus 1 by 4, 4 minus 1 equal 3, 3 by 4, 4 plus 1 equal 5, 5 by 4, 3 by 4 into 5 by 4, it will be 3 by 4 into 5 by 4, 1 by 2 into 3 by 2, so into T2, T2 nothing but 1 by 2 into 3 by 4, right? Similarly, T4, that means n equal to 3, 2n minus 1, simply apply here, 5 by 6 and 7 by 6 will get here, same right, n equal to 3, that 6 minus 1, 5 by 6, 6 plus 1 equal to 7 by 6, into T3, T is nothing but this row, T is nothing but this row. So 1 by 2 into 3 by 2, into 3 by like this will get. So for the product of this will be 5 by 2. As n tend to infinity, the product may be equal to Wallace product. As n tend to infinity, the product may be equal to the Wallace product. It is look like already we just now discussed it in the principles. So it may be converges to the Wallace product. And by using general method, you are unable to find limit. But by using this method, we may say that it may converge to Wallace product pi by 2. The whole product is equal to pi by 2. This thing will be explained, right? So, if the sequence Tn is defined by result to T1 equal to 1 and Tn plus 1 equal to like this, so Tn plus 1 equal to this, so 1 minus 4n square T into Tn 4n equal to 1, then we show a lim Tn exists. Lim Tn may be Wallace product. Lim Tn may be Wallace. What is the product we ask that by? I am writing that Lim Tn may be Wallace product. Try to double 9. Let T1 equal to 1 and Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 4, 1 by n plus 1 whole square into Tn for n equal to 1. So, Lim Tn exists. So that Lim Tn exists. B. What do you think of Lim Tn? Use induction to show Tn equal to n plus 1 by 2n. Use induction to show Tn equal to n plus 1 by 2n. D. Repeat part B. That means what do you think about Lim Tn is? So this is A. If a sequence Tn is defined by, T1 equal to 1 and Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 1 by n plus 1 whole square into Tn for n equal to 1. To show that Lim Tn is exist. To discuss about the Lim Tn. So see, by using induction to show Lim Tn equal to, to show that Tn equal to n plus 1 by 2n. B. Repeat part B. That means to discuss Lim Tn. Principles. Sequence. Bounded sequence. Increasing sequence. Decreasing sequence. Monotone sequence, monotone convergence theorem, mathematical induction and convergence. These are the required for proving that problem, for solving that problem. Let the sequence Tn defined by Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus n plus 1 whole square into Tn. So Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 1 by n plus 1 whole square into Tn. that equal to, if I double Tn minus Tn minus 1, which is less than Tn. Simply can observe that if I remove some terms from this, we get Tn less than T1. Tn less than Tn for all n belongs to n. Tn less than Tn for all n belongs to n. Tn is decreasing sequence, simply, right? So, last problem will be same. You can use the method alone, but I mean, use a different method. That's why Tn plus 1 is less than Tn. Here we can say that Tn is decreasing sequence. Tn is decreasing sequence. Tn is decreasing, it is monotone. Tn is decreasing, therefore it is monotone sequence. So, since Tn is decreasing, Tn is bounded of sequence. Decreasing sequence, Tn is bounded of sequence. And upper bound of Tn is T1 that equal to 1. Upper bound of Tn is T1 that equal to 1. Which implies Tn less than T1 for all n plus n. Tn less than T1 for all n plus n. Which implies Tn is less than equal to 1. T1 equal to already find that 1, therefore for all n plus n. That means we have found our 1. You can also here T1 equal to 1. See here node 1. T1 equal to 1 which is greater than 0. Same. T2 equal to here. T2 equal to what type n? 1 minus 1 plus 1 whole square by T1 that equal to. T1 equal to 1. Here 1 by 2 that equal 1 by 4. That means 3 by 4. 3 by 4 is greater than 0. It is true for n equal to 1. It is true for n equal to 1. It is true for n equal to k. That means I want to prove that it is true for n equal to k. If whatever tk is greater than 0. See, tk is greater than 0. I want multiply 1 minus k plus 1 whole square into tk. Here, yeah, this is k. Yeah, here we k. 1 minus 1 by k plus 1. 1 minus something will be positive only, which is greater than 0. Maybe it is point something, but it is maybe the 0. In tk, this is tk, already we know that tk, that's why it is so far equal to k, that means tk is greater than 0, which implies this term is written as tk plus 1, tk plus 1 greater than 0, here we can get tk, that means this term is all greater than equal to tk greater than 0. It is true for n equal to k plus 1, that means by induction, we shown that tn greater than 0 for all n belonging to n. Tn greater than 0 for all n belongs to n. This is true. From 1 and 2, what we know that 0 less than equal to Tn less than equal to 1. 0 less than equal to Tn less than equal to 1 from for all n belongs to n. Which implies Tn is bounded. Already we show that Tn is monotone and is bounded. All bounded monotone convergence theorem converges. Thereby applying monotone convergence theorem. By applying monotone convergence theorem, Tn is converges. That means limit of Tn is exist. I don't know about the limit of Tn, but the limit of Tn is exist. So by applying monotone theorem, we show that this all bounded monotone converges. That's why this also converges and limit Tn exists. B. Limit. Let limit Tn equal L. Okay. What do you think of limit Tn? That's why I'm writing here limit Tn equal L. I'm answering. Lim Tn plus 1 equal to also L. Lim Tn equal to L, Lim Tn plus 1 equal to L. That means, so what is Lim Tn plus 1? In place of Tn plus I substitute 1 minus 4 n plus 1 whole square into Tn. If I multiply this Tn by Tn minus n plus 1 equal to L, the Lim Tn by Lim of n plus 1 whole square that equal to L. Lim Tn equal to L, Lim Tn equal to L. This is infinite. Infinite that equal to L. L by infinite equal to 0. That is L equal to L. So that means L equal to L. We are unable to find any limit, that's why we are unable to determine the limit of sequence by using this method. So, the limit of sequence is unable to determine. To show that Tn is n plus 1 that equal by 2n by induction. Right? Tn, I want to have Tn equal to n plus 1 by 2n by induction. I want to show this above sequence, above Tn is same as this Tn. Let T1 equal to 1 and Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 1 by n plus 1 whole square into Tn. T1 equal to 1 and Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus y 1 by n plus 1 whole square equal to Tn. This thing we know that. T2 is equal to T1 plus 1. T2 is equal to T1 plus 1. Nothing but 1 minus 1 by 1 plus 1 into T1. So 1 by 2 square that equal to 3 by 4. So that means 3 by 4. T2 equal to 3 by 4. T2 is equal to what happen? See, I want to show this to equal to same as like this by induction. I define T1 equal to 1 and TL plus 1 equal to this. T2 equal to what happened? This is 3 by 4. T2 equal same as I want to apply there also. 2, this can be written as 2 plus 1 by 2 into 2. So 2n plus 1 by 2n like this. It is true for n equal to 1, I am writing. That is true for n equal to k. That means tk is equal to, I am writing here, a k plus 1 by 2k plus 1. K plus 1 by 2k plus 1. I am taking this is so. My turn. I have considered ek plus 1. That equal to 1 minus 1 by 4 k plus 1 also by tk. Tk nothing but k plus 1 by 2k. Tk nothing but k plus 1 by 2k. By cross multiply this k plus 1 whole square minus 1 by k plus 1 whole square into this tk nothing but k plus 1 by 2k. Here k plus 1 whole square nothing but k square plus 2k plus 1 minus 1. Here k plus 1 square, k plus 1 whole square. This is k plus 1 cancel out. What happened? 2k into k plus 1. 2k into k plus 1, right? This is 1, 1 gets cancel out. So I want to write this is here 1, 1 will cancel out. Here k times of k plus 2, right? So that means so what I am doing here. If you take k common out, 1 1 will cancel out here simply. K square plus 2k. If I take k common out, k get cancel out. K cancel out. But what happened? K plus 2 will get comes here. Here we will get our k plus 2. Here we will get k plus 2. So this term can be written as here. K plus 2k plus 1 minus 1 is there by what are terms we have here 2k into k plus 1 here. If I take common out here, if I take this tk plus 1, right? Tk plus 1 equal to this. K square plus 2k, 1 minus 1, 1 1 cancel out. Here 1 1 1 minus 1 is cancel out. That equal to if I take k common out here. K by k plus 2 by this 1 cancel. If put on your k square plus 2k. Here 2k so what happened here k cancel out to here k plus 2 can ask k plus 1 plus 1 by 2 times of k plus 1. So tk plus 1, that means so it is true for k plus 1 also. That means it is in the form n plus 1. So I want to show that tn equal to n plus 1 by 2n. So it is implied, that means so it is true for n equal to k plus 1 also. It is true for n equal to k plus 1 also, right? But rather, I can show that this. So that means we shown that it is true for n equal to k plus 1. By induction, it is true for n equal to, for all n plus n. It is true for n equal to n, right? Limit n, I find limit n equal to limit of n plus 1 by 2n. That equal 1 by 2, if I multiply this 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2n. This limit of 1 by 2 equal to 1 by 2, this will be 0. So limit of tn equal to 1 by 2. That means the limit of tn is 1 by 2, the above sequence also. Both are same sequence. That's why I'm saying that this limit of tn equal to 1 by 2 is same as the above limit. So the earlier problem we are discussing about the Pythagoras product, this product is defined is using other sequence. The limit of the sequence is defined as 1 by 2. Okay. Result. So if the sequence Tn is defined by T1 equal to 1 and Tn plus 1 equal to 1 minus 1 by n plus 1 whole square into Tn for all n greater than 1, we show that limit n is exist and unable to determine the limit n by using the wave method. We show Tn equal to n plus 1 by 2n by induction. We show that limit n equal to Tn equal to n plus 1. Therefore, Tn will be same as n plus 1 by induction. So, and find that limit of Tn equal to 1 by 2. That means we are discussing the limit of the sequence equal 1 by 2 by using the above method. Other practical problem. S1 equal to 1, let S1 equal to 1 and Sn plus 1 equal to 1 by 3, Sn plus 1, 4. Sn plus 1 for here, it is Sn plus 1 here. Sn plus 1 for algorithm. Find S1, S2, S3 and S4. Use induction to show that Sn greater than 1 by 2. For all n belongs to n, show Sn is the sequence, show limit Sn is exist and find limit Sn. A sequence Sn is defined by S1 equal to 1 and Sn plus 1 equal to defined by 1 by 3 into Sn plus 1. 1 by 3 into Sn plus 1. So to show that limit Sn equal to 1 by 2 for all n belongs to n, to show Sn is decreasing sequence, to show limit Sn is exist and find limit. Principal sequence, bounded sequence, convex sequence, decreasing sequence, Swanton sequence, Swanton convex theorem, mathematical induction. The sequence Sn is defined by S1 equal to 1 and Sn plus 1 equal to 1 by 3 into Sn plus 1 here. Not Sn plus 1, Sn plus 1 for all n belongs to n. S1 equal to 1. S2 is equal to Sn S1 plus 1. So S1 equal to how much here? 1 by 3 here. S2 equal to S1 plus 1. That equal to 1 by 3. S1 plus 1. S1 nothing but 1. 1 plus 1. That equal to 2 by 3. S2 equal to 2 by 3. S3 equal to S2 plus 1. So 1 by 3 times of here S2 plus 1. S3 equal to S2 plus 1. That equal to 1 by 3 into S2 plus 1, that equal S1 equal 2 by 3, S3 equal 5 by 3. S4, we have to find S4. S4 equal S3 plus 1, that equal to 1 by 3 times of S3 plus 1. The S3 equal 5 by 3, that equal to S4 equal 14 by 27. So, already find first 4 terms of it. Let S1 equal to 1, which is greater than 1 by 2, S2 is equal to 2 by 3, is equal to 1 by 2. So, I want to show that Sn is greater than 1 by 2, that's why I am taking induction S1 equal to 1, that is greater than 1 by 2. S2 equal to 2 by 3, which is also greater than 1 by 2. That means 2 by 3 nothing but 0.6, 1 by 2 nothing but 0.5. It is to 4 n equal to 1. You can observe all terms here. It is 0.2 of only, which is greater than 0.5 of, which is greater than 0.5 of only. So all terms are greater than 2 only. I am taking that it is true for n equal to 1. I want to prove this by mathematical induction. That's why it is true for n equal to k. That means Sk is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. Sk is greater than 1 by 2. Let Sk plus 1 equal to what happened? 1 by 3 into Sk plus 1. I am taking the Sk plus 1 equal to 1 by 3 Sk. Sk equal to how much here? 1 by 2. Sk greater than this is 1 by 2 plus 1. 1 by 3 into 3 by 2. This is apply here 3 by 2. 3 the k cancel 1 by 2. Sk plus 1 is greater than 1 by 2. Sk plus 1 is greater than 1 by 2. It is true for n equal to k plus 1. It is true for n equal to k. By induction, it is true for all n belongs to n. By induction, it is true for all n belongs to n. That means Sn is greater than or equal to 1 by 2. We show that Sn is greater than 1 by 2. We show. Let S1 is equal to 1, it is greater than 0, and Sn minus Sn plus 1, I am considering Sn minus Sn plus 1. Sn nothing but Sn, Sn plus 1 is 1 by 3 times of Sn plus 1. If I cross multiply, then what happens? 3 Sn minus Sn minus 1 by 3. 3 Sn minus Sn equal to 2 Sn minus 1 by 3. Sn greater than or equal to 1 by 2, that means Sn greater than 1 by 2, 2 times of 1 by 2 minus 1, that equal to by 3. Here greater than 1 by 2, 2 to cancel 1, 1 minus 1 equal to 0, that equal to 0. That means Sn minus Sn plus 1 is greater than 0. Sn minus Sn plus 1 is greater than 0 for all n belongs to n. Sn is greater than 1 by 2 for n belonging to n. Which implies Sn is greater than Sn plus 1 for all n belongs to n. Sn is decreasing sequence. So, we shown that Sn is greater than 1 by 2 and Sn is greater than Sn is decreasing sequence. So, since Sn is decreasing sequence, from C we know that Sn is decreasing sequence. Sn is monotone sequence by principle. Right? We know that Sn is decreasing, Sn is monotone sequence. Since Sn is decreasing, we know that Sn is bounded above sequence and lower upper bound of Sn is S1. Since Sn is bounded above sequence, decreasing nothing but Sn is bounded above sequence and lower upper bound of Sn is S1. S1 equal to 1. s1 equal to 1, which implies sn is less than or equal to 1 for all n belongs to n. This is 1. Sn is less than or equal to 1 for all n belongs to n. This is 1. From b and 1, here you can write the from b from 1, we know that already we shown that sn is greater than 1 by 2, that means 1 by 2 is less than sn, and sn is less than or equal to 1, that means 1 by 2 is less than sn is less than 1 by for all n belongs to n. Sn is bounded. Already we know that Sn is monotone. Sn is bounded and Sn is monotone. By applying monotone convergent theorem, Sn is converges. That means limit Sn is exist. I am considering limit Sn equal to L, which implies limit Sn plus 1 equal to L. Sn plus nothing but 1 by 3 times of Sn plus 1, Sn plus 1, that equal to L. Here written as 1 by 3 times limit Sn plus limit 1, that equal to 1. 1 by 3, L plus 1, that equal to L, L plus 1 equal to 3L, 2L equal to L, L equal to 1 by 2, limit Sn equal to 1 by 2, right. Result, if the sequence Sn is defined by S1 equal to 1 and Sn plus 1 equal to 1 by 3 into Sn plus 1, so we found S1, S2, S3, S4, and then we shown Sn greater than 1 by 2 by induction, then we shown Sn is decreasing sequence, then we show that Sn is okay, other problem. I can do your own. Sn equal to n by n square plus 1, then prove that Sn is decreasing and bounded below sequence. If S1 equal to Sn equal to 1 by 1 by 3 square, then prove that Sn is converges. If the sequence Sn is defined by Xn1 equal to 1, Xn plus 1 equal to 2Xn by Xn plus 1, then show that Sn is decreasing and converges to 1 by 2. If the sequence Sn is 1 by 2, 1 plus 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by n minus log n, then show that Sn is decreasing and converges. Right. Note, every bounded sequence has limit point. Every bounded sequence has a limit point. SJS, not AS. Every bounded sequence has a limit point. The statement made by Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem. The statement made by Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem. That means every bounded sequence has limit point to a statement made by Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem. Right. If Sn equal to this, 1 by 2 this, Sn plus 1 equal to this. So this higher problems already we discussed, I quickly explain. Sn minus Sn plus 1 is less than 0 for all n belongs to n. So why? Because Sn plus 1, this term is over Sn. If you write this Sn, or you can say that if you write this Sn minus Sn plus whatever, this okay, term cancel out. We will get this is minus of this term, which is less than 0, Sn less than 0, so Sn decreasing. Sn is increasing sequence, Sn is monotone. Sn is increasing since Sn is bounded below sequence. If the increase sequence is bounded below sequence, layer bound of Sn is S1, and S1 is less than or equal to Sn for all n 10. Here S1 equal to 4 by 3, and 4 by 3 less than or equal to Sn. So I want to write this, rewrite this formula is so by 1 plus r plus r squared data, so the form will be right. If you write this form, 1 minus 1 by 3 whole power n plus 1 by 1 minus, that equal to, we will get here 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2 whole power n plus. That means this term is less than 3 by 2. This term is less than 3 by 2. Sn is less than or equal to 3 by 2. So Sn is bounded. Already we know that 1 by 4 by 3 is less than or equal to Sn, less than 3 by 2. Sn is bounded. Sn is bounded and monotone. By monotone convergence theorem, it is converges to 3 by 2. So how much here? This is 3 by 2, converges to 3 by 2. Not need not write here. Yeah, simply that Sn equal to 3 by 2, 1 by 2 power n plus 1, that equal to lim of 3 by 2 minus lim of 1 by 2 power, that equal to 1 by infinite, that equal to 0, that equal to lim of 3 by 2. So Sn converges to 3 by 2, not 3 here. So these are the problems we have discussed in these applications of Bolzano-Weierstrass theorem. Thank you for watching this lecture. Thank you one and all.